Hello everyone, I'm Yatin. I work at SocialCops. Before I start to talk about building for next billion, let me tell you what we do at SocialCops. SocialCops is a data company that exists to derive decisions that can solve problems that matter. For example, Google tells us the quickest route home, but not the safest. I can find a restaurant around me in 2 minutes, but what about finding a great school for my sister? Now, before you start to talk about predictive analytics and visualization, the problem here to solve for is there is no data. So we built Collect. Collect is a data collection tool that has been put into hands of over 150 nonprofits that leverage their field volunteers to collect data from remote parts of the world. Collect has been used for disaster management during Nepal earthquake, maternal mortality in Uttar Pradesh, and then water and sanitation management in Indonesia, and also for village development in Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, and Jharkhand. So, after writing 46K lines of code, collecting over 30 million data points, and 50 field visits later, here's what I have learned about building for the next billion. So this is our average user. Who is she? She is Promila. She's a 7th class pass. She can read, write, and speak only in Marathi. She lives in Raigad in rural Maharashtra. Recently, I visited rural Maharashtra and there is lack of internet access and electricity. This is her first interaction with a smartphone, which costs rupees 2000 and 3000. So while building for Promila, I learned my first lesson, colors for next billion. Whenever a user answers a question, so Collect is basically a questionnaire app, so there are different questions on that. So if a user answers some question on the Collect, so question number turns green, giving a notification to user that you have answered this question. But due to some buggy code, a question is not, for one of the question type, the question number was not turning green. That was a small bug for a developer, but during a field visit, a field volunteer came and said, "Sir, ye hari batti nahi jal rahi hai." So that was a big worry for a field volunteer. Imagine your grandparents, when they use a mobile phone, they will feel that they will break it. But how happy they will feel when they can play music or talk to you over video. We're dealing with the same audience type. And also field workers like interact with phone on the field when there is a large sunlight. So using contrasting colors actually helps greatly in ensuring that users understand app faster. Now as we talked about icons, let's talk about how to use icons. How many of you know what does this icon mean? Everyone does, right? This is simple. But for a field volunteer, this is something new. He doesn't know what does this icon mean. So using text with your icons, like if you can see there, if we use text with the icons, it actually helps field volunteers or the users who are coming to using the phone for the first time, that what does this icon mean? They will actually know ki if I press this button or this icon, what will happen. Now, as I mentioned, Promila can speak only in Marathi, right? And read only in Marathi. So let's talk about language for the next billion. So as Promila can speak, read only in Marathi, so we included Marathi language in the Collect app. But Promila was using an eyeball tab, which does not support Marathi as a default language in the language settings, which is a problem with, I think, all the low-cost devices. So what we did was we included the change language button inside the app itself and gave user an option to select a language from a list of supported languages which is present in the Collect app. So if you're building for next billion, language has to be an app feature and not to rely on the phone. Yeah. So this is a basic, this is a list of languages we had in collect, and we gave a button so that user can select from this list of languages in the app itself, instead of going into settings in the phone and changing the language, because you are not sure which phone is user is using, right? So we included it in the app itself, so it doesn't matter the phone he is using, he can directly select a language from the app itself. Now let's move on to our lesson number 4, which is building for infrastructure constraints. Before that, let me show you an interesting picture. So this is an image of tablets being charged at night during one of our deployments in Maharashtra. So if you can see, like there is one extension and then there is one charger connected, one extension is connected to another extension, and these, like, so there during a deployment, like there are about 350 to 400 tablets that we need to charge. And area in, like, as collect is deployed in areas like Raigarh, where there is lack of electricity also. So, and field worker is always on the field during the daytime, and he is only able to charge only at night. That is also when electricity is present. So we can't consume large amount of battery, right? So best option, like good practices would be if we are building for next billion or for the people who belong to rural areas, right? So best option will be not to run background services all the time. Like background services consume a large amount of battery, as we all know, right? And then not to track the location. Like it's better to track the location only when we need it, not to track location every time. That is another main cause for battery drain. Another thing we can do is we can use Battery Historian, which is present in Android Studio, which is a great tool to track battery consumption by the app. So as we talked about battery, let's move on to network, which takes us to our most important lesson, building for offline world. So as Collect is being deployed in areas like Raigarh, right? So in that demographic area, the internet is very slow or not at all present. The average speed there is about 10 kbps or 20 kbps. Not like 5-10 Mbps where we test our app and generally we say, yeah, we did this thing, yeah, it's working. So yeah. Collect experience has to work offline. We can't say that, like, we are not able to download your data because you are on slow internet, because the main audience we are dealing with is in rural area. So we can't complain that you have a slow internet or something. It has to work offline. So what we did was to give offline support, either we can follow anything, like we can go to with SQLite, which is a traditional way of doing giving offline support, or we can use Realm. Realm is a mobile-based database, and it's very simple and way faster than ORM-based SQLite available currently in the market. Another thing is creating a seamless experience. As Collect is being used by people who are using a low-cost device, which is worth rupees 2,000 and 3,000, and they have a low memory and certain issues, so it's very difficult to provide them a seamless experience. No matter how many null pointer and out of memory exceptions we add, but it's very difficult to give them a seamless experience, and nobody wants to see this message on a screen like your app has crashed, right? So like in Collect we have generally in a questionnaire there are 150 questions, and if you answer, suppose I answer 50 questions and then app crashed or phone goes off, that will be frustrating, right? Like I will feel like let me uninstall this app, right? But we gave an autosave feature, so whenever a user answers a response, it will automatically get saved, no matter whether app goes off or app crashes. The data will be saved always, like he can come back to the app and see the data. Ultimately, like we are building for people who are using phone for the first time, and also they don't know how to report bugs. They can't come onto Google Play services and say that, like, give a feedback that this is the bug or this is the problem I am facing. So what I have learned in the last 1 year or something, the best way is to go on field, ask your users, see how they are interacting with the app, how they are, observe their behavior with your app, talk to them, take feedback. I feel this is the best way we can build for the next billion. This is an image of a field training during Vijayawada deployment. So there were people who were using paper for I think their whole lifetime, and they are taking surveys on paper. And this is the first time they were using a tablet. So at the start of the session, we need to train them how to swipe, how to turn on and turn off GPS. And also at the end of the training, we generally ask them a question, how you feel about the, like, whether you want to use a paper again or you want to use mobile. And this is the number of people who said we will use mobile. And this gives you a satisfaction that, like, if you see people who are using phone for the first time and they are using mobile app for the, like, and the app they are using is the UR app, right? And this gives you a satisfaction. This is all about I have to say about Nextpillion. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Any questions you want? Sorry? We are using RHEL. And plus the file storage as a backup. So we have two methods basically, because most of the users are like from rural area. They can log out at any point of time, right? So we need to keep a backup. So tomorrow, if they log out by a mistake or something, so we have a backup of data like they have. Because if they log in again, we will have a backup. No, auto saving is basically, like we save draft, right? So whenever some user answers the question, we will basically trigger a method of like saving it into the realm itself. So there is an object, basically answer object, which will automatically get saved. Okay, so basically it's not still production ready. Like they are releasing updates every week. When I started, it was 0.60. Now it's 0.86. I think they recently released a new version. So they are also removing, but there are some thread issues also. Like you can't use an object from one to another thread, and there are some certain other issues also. Like if you want to write, you can't write object at the same time. Like you need to make a synchronous module to write objects directly.
Then if those are the issues, then still why you are using SQR?
Because Realm is provides you object-oriented support also. Like it's a good structure, then you can define keys also. But the like if you can write a good quality code, like you can synchronize all the calls, then it's like you can go with Realm also. Like it will take a huge time at the first, but once you are comfortable with it, it's like very good database.
Have you used data migration as well? Migration on Realm.
Migration is there in Realm, so they are building that. So,
what kind of feature is that? Like, is it good?
Okay,
bad?
So migration is basically something they are developing it. There is no like they haven't documented it properly. But if you like debug it or try to build it, sit for 2 to 3 days, you will be able to figure out like how to do it properly.
Have you compared it with any of the ORM existing, like GreenDAO or something? Realm.
No, I have tried, Active ORM. Android.
Okay.
There is Active Android, I think, which is a SQL lightweight, but I liked Realm more, so
okay.
I checked it.
Any more questions? We have about five minutes more.
So as you are having that string option in the app itself, like not from the settings, right?
The language.
Language.
Language is in the app itself. So if you want to select some language, like I want to see my app in Marathi, so I can just go into the settings of the app and then change from there.
So have you abstracted out to something? Because like if you are doing it from the Android perspective, it manages it all.
But the problem we faced is like in low-cost devices, there is no language option. Some languages are not there.
No.
Like I want to see Marathi, right?
Yeah, so, that's fine. So my question is like how you abstracted it out? Like have you inflated the layouts again or like?
No, so there is something in Android which is localization.
Yeah.
So you can use localization and call that function and you can change the language. So that is basically per session based.
Okay.
That is so it won't change permanently for all the apps on the phone. It will just change for that app.
Okay, thank you, Yatin.
Thank you.